You'll have different kinds of people who would try different kinds of ways to influence your decisions. But honesty, integrity, your value system needs to be very strong.
I came to Dubai in 1963, March, from Bahrain. I joined the bank called National Bank of Dubai, which is called now Emirates NBD. I worked there for 6 years. And then I shifted to Commercial Bank of Dubai. CBD started in 1969,
yeah.
October. I joined the bank in 1969, July. We were 20 staff with the bank. We started, I was one of them. Then 1975, I was sent to Athens, Greece for some training course. I was there for 9 months. Did the course, banking course, came back. And I worked for the bank from 1969 to 2011, 42 years. I really enjoyed my working with the bank. And I joined as a senior clerk, and when I retired, I was a senior manager, marketing and credit. Still, I enjoy my good rapport with the staff, of course, not changed, so old clients, and I keep in touch with them and really enjoy. I love Dubai, it's our home. My children, my grandchildren are born here.
Dubai has given us a wonderful platform. We wouldn't be what we are today if it wasn't for the wonderful platform, the bedrock that the royal family, the Maktoum family, has set up. I think we all owe it a lot to His Highness, the late His Highness Sheikh Rashid bin Saeed Al Maktoum. He was wonderful towards the Indian expatriate community. He was responsible for giving land for the temple. He also gave us the land for the Indian High School, which is now celebrating 60 years, the school that I work very closely with currently. So again, the UAE and the rulers have been very benevolent. Have done so much for all of us, and like my father rightly said, this is home away from home. This is a very interesting story. When both my, when my sisters and I were growing up, and we lived in a very modest house in Bur Dubai, and my father, being a banker, once he came home with a very small gift that was given to by a client, and I was a slightly naughty one in the family, so I would get to open the gifts. So when I opened the gift, I saw it was something insignificant, and I threw it on the ground. So my father came into the room and he said, "What is it?" And I said, "I don't know." And actually, it was a key to a car, right, which he was given as a gift by somebody. So he said, "Put that back in the box." And I said, "Why?" He said, "No, we got to give it back to the person who gave it to us." So then he put it back, and then he went and he returned it. And then he came back with another box, another gift, right, that was given. And again, I opened it. And again, it's insignificant. And it was a necklace that the same person had given. And again, his view was, look, it's not right to accept such gifts. We got to do our duty. So again, he put it back in. Again, he drove back to the gentleman. The third time he came back home, again, opened the gift. It was a packet of coasters. In those days, you give the coasters. And he said, "Yeah, this we can keep." So that's something I learned from my father from a very young age in terms of honesty and integrity. That you'll have different kinds of people who would try different kinds of ways to influence your decisions. But honesty, integrity, your value system needs to be very strong. So I think that's had a huge impact on my sisters and I. And that's something which we embody and we take forward. And hopefully we will be passing that on to the next generation. Like you're aware, now he has his grandkids, so we are the fourth generation in the UAE. And hopefully we'll be able to pass on these values which my father so wonderfully personifies.